Hello and welcome to a GridMarkets tutorial for how to set up a scene. Here we have a simple scene that is set up with a filament ball in the middle and a simple three light setup and a studio. The filament ball is being set up to be simmed out for geometry caching. I have both a simulation and a regular geometry cache setup so that you can see how to set up each. For this, the major difference between the two is this batch all frames on a single machine that is setting it for a time-dependent simulation. Things like your pyros or your solver nodes are going to need to be cached using this to prevent them from caching and simulating on the render machines themselves. In cases that are non-time dependent, that you need to cache out a frame, you want to uncheck this, and that will cause it to function similar to a regular render where you'll be allocated up to your maximum number of machines to do the geometry caching. This is really useful in situations like water, like when you're doing a ocean simulation or a water surfacing, or dealing with volumes from particles and such that can easily take 10 or 15 minutes per frame to calculate. Setting it to be an unbatched geometry cache on GridMarkets can net up a lot of time saved in that situation. So I have this set up for both. It is this, in this case, I would be using the geometry cache since nothing is simulated. It is entirely done using mathematics and it's entirely time independent. So it is not necessary to do the simulation. I have this here simply to show how it works. Once you have that set up, you are going to want to select these two buttons here, the spawn ROP, spawn read. This spawns a ROP inside of the ROP context. This spawns a read here locally inside of the current geometry node. You are going to want to do this and make sure that your render flag and probably your display flag are set below them in your network, because if you do not do this, you run the risk of accidentally having a render machine try to simulate the simulation or not pull the geometry cache, which can be quite costly, because frame one will simulate to frame one. Frame two, the machine that's rendering frame two, will now need to simulate frame one and frame two. And three needs to do one, two, and three, and so on for the duration of your render. This can add enormous amounts of time, even for quick simulations. It is always recommended that you, and considered mandatory, that you cache out any simulations that are being done. Moving on to the out context, I have the render submit node here. It defaults to the frame range and $RFEND. This is the default setting for the render submit node. And when you have it set like this, the frame ranges are going to be, and all of your nodes are going to be overridden by this frame range. As a matter of fact, when you have a frame range on here, it's going to override all of the input nodes. There is a way to prevent that. I will show that shortly. Additionally to that, there is a way to do a custom setup, which allows you to set frame ranges. So I want, say, frame range 1. I want frames 10 to 20, I want that to skip 2, so I get every other frame from 10 to 20, and I want frame 100. This allows you to specify certain frames to get back as test frames from any nodes you have as inputs. I only want the one frame though, so I will clear that for the time being. Here are our two camera angles. We will be setting up a series of layouts just to show how they work. In this configuration, you're going to have a pair of serial renders. GridMarkets honors dependency chains entirely. So in this configuration, the render dolly left would be rendered first, and then the render depth of field rack would be rendered after that. And it will only start, and this is the big thing to remember, the depth of field rack will only start once all frames on render dolly left have finished. In a production situation, you would definitely want to use a parallel on these two cameras. In this configuration, GridMarkets will attempt to render both renders in parallel. It will start with render dolly left, and as render dolly left finishes and machines in your quota become available, render depth of field rack will start picking up those machines and start rendering its frames. This means that jobs will flow from one to the other as they finish. Here are the two geometry caches. They're both caching the same geometry, but we're going to pretend for a minute that they're not. As I mentioned before, the dependencies are entirely honored. So if we take these two and we make these renders dependent on them, what will happen is the render the CC sim will do its simulation, and when it finishes, render dolly left will start. In parallel to the simulation, this geometry cache will run, and this depth of field render will start when the geometry cache is finished. How this will end up working is the simulation runs on a single machine. If your quota is set to standard, you will have access to 30 machines, meaning the balance of the 29 machines will be picked up and run on the geometry cache. This can allow you to finish several simulations in parallel and make sure to control what was rendered and when, so you can have entire complex scenes rendered off of the caches for what is needed between them. With the nodes and dependency graph being entirely honored, if you were to need CC sim on the depth of field rack, you are able to wire it into the depth of field rack. Now this simulation, this render will wait for both of these to finish, but Dolly will still only wait on the simulation. In the case where you need everything to be mutually dependent, it is entirely possible to wire things like this, but that gets a little bit messy. In this case, the reasonable thing to do is to bring a merge node in, which allows you to merge those two, and then each of these is now dependent on the merge, which is dependent on both geometry caches. This makes it so that the two geometry caches, will finish in parallel, and then only when both of them are finished will the renders begin. It is also possible, and this is common to use in the case of a water simulation, where you will first do your simulation for the water, and then you will do the simulate. Then you will go through and surface the water, and then render. You can also, in this case, as another case, this could be a whitewater. In the whitewater case, you would have your pop simulation going into the whitewater to be done in parallel with the surfacing, which is then all required to be finished. Given that this render does not necessarily need this sim, I will set it to the side along with the merge node. In order to control what frames are rendered on a given thing, on a given submission, the frame range here, as I said before, will override all of the inputs frame ranges. To prevent that, you simply come to the valid frame range on the node and set it to render frame range only strict. This will tell GridMarkets that the frame range on this job needs to be completed in its entirety. This is useful in cases such as simulations and geometry caches where you know the cache or the simulation is right, but you need to do some look dev work. So you're rendering test frames with your render nodes, but you want the entire thing cached so you do not need to do it later. Or in cases where a single frame is being rendered, but you need to cache out all the way up to that frame, you would say let's say frame 25 is needing to be rendered as your test frame. This would allow all frames 1 to 96 or 1 to 25, if you set it so, to be simulated and cached, but only frame 25 would be rendered on the two camera angles. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned for upcoming videos on the pre-flight process and the environment and advanced tabs. Thank you.